I'll try one more time. Are you ready?
Yes!
That's better. Right, I'll see if you can reach 20 of you two.
Many lives. driver, ladies and gentlemen. Now, although we may not be able to travel with the doctor using this device, we're going to trace his exact location in time. And there he is, the doctor himself in his tired body tie.
Come up here. Well, we are standing in the TARDIS. And it really is bigger on the inside. But did anyone see the doctor come in?
No.
Oh, that's not helpful. He should be here, shouldn't he? Well, let me just see if I can find him. You guys just stick around for a minute. I'll have a look around. He's probably around here somewhere. Doctor? Doctor, are you here?
I couldn't wait for you. You're too slow.
He's here, guys.
You look. Go and stand around the console. Small adults at the front. Big kids at the back.
Yeah, I rather think you mean all children at the front. What?
I've come down here to figure out what this thing is. Turns out those time squid things are actually all part of one creature. The Crinus. It's latched onto the TARDIS. It's going to try to raise me from history.
Oh, that's not good.
We haven't gone long. So if you don't understand what I'm talking about, it doesn't matter. It's just because you're very, very stupid. And almost certainly doomed. So why worry? Now, to stop the Crinus, we need to get 3 TARDIS energy crystals, which would be easy if the crystals hadn't been scattered all through time. Long story, there was a card game, a space hammer, and never mind. Those crystals will make the TARDIS stronger, so it can eject the Crinus back into the vortex, and you lot could go home and eat cornflakes, or whatever you do to pass your tiny little lifespans. I've located the first crystal and set the coordinates, but listen, it's not going to be safe. So just do what boy girl in the dress says.
Girl.
If you're lucky, you'll stay alive. Got it?
I think so.
Right.
Okay.
We have to manually control the TARDIS.
What?
You little people at the front, see those controls? Hold on to them. Pull them down. Not yet. When I say something. Everyone else, take your passes and hold them up in the air.
Hold them up, everyone. Hold them up, Like this?
No. Take your time. It's not like it's a matter of life and death or anything.
No higher before he gets cranky.
Right. Now, move those controls to the right.
Are you ready, guys?
To the right.
Uh-oh.
And off we go.
I've got one question about all this. Does anyone actually know how to put it up? One person, okay. No, we'll have to start from scratch, won't we? Now, first things first, try going right to left, right to left, right to left. Okay, now go to the left. We must be locked onto that planet there. So, spinky levers, have excellent cut out of the sphere. Up in the air, just up there. Come on, that's it. Now, it's hard to think. So, move up. Go to the right. Pull the levers down. Pull it
on the planet Scarab.
Hello!
Warning, you have landed on the planet Scarab. Warning, you have landed on the planet Scarab.
Scarab is the home planet of two races, the Thals and the Carlets. Many centuries ago, a Carlet scientist, Danfross, created travel machines for his mutated people to live in. These mutations became the Daleks. The Daleks then exterminated the entire Thal race before traveling out into space and declaring war on the universe. The Time Lords were forced to intervene, an act which led to the last great Time War. They are the deadliest creatures that have ever lived, but now, thanks to the Time Lords, they are extinct. This planet is all that remains of their race. You are advised to leave at once.
You have landed on the planet Scarab. Yeah. Warning.
Right, I don't think we need any more warnings, do you? Well, I really think we ought to get out of here now. You do have to find the first time, Crystal. So, anyone see anything? No, sorry, excuse me. Darling, now.
no, I'm so scared.
Keep going, guys. Stop. Keep going.
Oh.
All right, guys. All right.
Oh,
all right.
My.
Keep going.
Oh, my.
You're all right, Rocco. Keep your eyes on them, okay? These guys are very peckish. Alright, keep going, guys. Keep going. Alright, guys. Now then, we don't have a lot of time. We've got to find the second time, Crystal, so just keep your eyes out there, okay? Oh, there he is. Take a look at that one. Look at her. Look at all of them, okay? They are hiding the crystal from us. They're not being very charitable. They won't give it up to us in a hurry. So come on, Angel, just show us where the crystal is. Just give it to us. You don't have to pop! Now, there's the second crystal, so who's going to help me? Who's going to help me get it? I've already got one who would like to help me. Let's see if you help me get it. Oh, come on! It's okay!
This is the doctor calling boy, girl in the dress.
Doctor?
The crisis is going through the TARDIS's memory banks. They're visiting all the places I've visited. Different times and places are being merged together. Do you understand?
Kind of busy down here.
Useless. Time-space mashup. The pyramids are now in Paris. The universe is collapsing in on itself. I've managed to send you some protective atmospheric density glasses.
Wait, what?
You'll need those to walk safely through the next time distortion. Now, do you understand?
No.
You'll find some glasses. When you meet the Crimus, put them on. What now? The Mary Celeste just turned up in some place called Cardiff. Cardiff?
Cardiff?
Find the third crystal. I've knocked up a device that will send the energy of the crystal back through the vortex and into the TARDIS. Put the three crystals in it, and that should stop the Crimus. Keep walking quickly.
Let's get out of here, yeah?
Over and out.
Yeah, come on.
There.
Of course you're not. You know exactly. So rude.
Now, Doctor, what do I do?
Doctor! Sorry, I don't know why I'm doing this!
1,000 people.
Not bad, I don't know.
1963. November 1963. The junkyard, 76 Totters Lane. Huh. Reminds me of something, but I can't place it.
Hello.
Come on. Better get you all back home. Oh, and give boy girl your glasses.
Yeah.
It's not safe to keep them in the TARDIS, and well, you do all look pretty stupid. See you soon, kids.
See you around, Doctor. Hang on. If it's I see you soon. Doctor, hang on! You do need